Our story today is about a man born with wings on his feet. He gave up the opportunity for Olympic gold in his best event because of his principles. The film Chariots of Fire was made in 1981 to tell his story. His name is Eric Liddell. Eric Liddell was born in 1902 in Tientsin in North China. His father and mother were missionaries and there with the London Missionary Society. He was educated in Eltham Boarding School in London while his parents and sister Jenny returned to China. At Eltham, Liddell was an outstanding sportsman. He was the best athlete of his year, playing for the first 11 cricket team and the first 15 rugby team by the age of 15. Later, he became captain of both the cricket and rugby union teams. Yet his headmaster described him as being entirely without vanity. He went to Edinburgh University in 1920. He played rugby for Edinburgh University and in 1922 played for Scotland in 7 internationals. He was also a runner and he ran in the 100 yards and the 220 yards for Edinburgh University and later for Scotland. In 1923, he won the AAA Championships in athletics in the 100 yards, setting a British record of 9.7 seconds that would not be broken for 35 years. Liddell became well known for being the fastest runner in Scotland. Newspapers ran stories of his feats at track meets and many articles stated that he was a potential Olympic winner. He was aiming to compete in the 100 metres in the Paris Olympics in 1924, but then learned that the heats were to be run on a Sunday. He was a devout Christian and would not run on the Christian Sabbath, so he switched to the 400 metre competition. He was not recognised as a 400 metres runner, but amazingly, he won the final and broke the existing Olympic and world records with a time of 47.6 seconds. He also won a bronze medal for the 200 metres at the Paris Olympics. After the Olympics and his graduation, he returned to North China, where he served as a missionary from 1925 until he died in 1945, firstly in Tientsin and later in Xichang. Liddell's first job as a missionary was as a teacher at an Anglo-Chinese college. Liddell also trained boys in a number of different sports. One of his main responsibilities was that of the superintendent of the Sunday school at Union Church, where his father was pastor. During his first furlough in 1932, he was ordained as a minister. On his return to China, he married Canadian Florence Mackenzie in 1934. The villages Liddell worked in suffered many hardships as a result of warring between Chinese communists and nationalists. On one day, the communists would pillage and destroy a village and then leave. Later, on another day, the nationalists would come and do the same thing. On one occasion, he was asked if he ever regretted his decision to do Christian work and leave behind the fame and glory athletics. Liddell responded, "It's natural for a chap to think over all that sometimes, but I'm glad I'm at the work I'm engaged in now. A fellow's life counts far more at this than the other." Due to the Japanese invasion of China in 1940, the British government advised British nationals to leave. Eric's wife Florence and their children left for Canada, but Eric decided to stay. In 1943, he was interned in a Japanese camp. While others fretted in the camp, Liddell busied himself by helping the elderly, teaching children Bible classes and science, and arranging games for the children. The children called him Uncle Eric. Liddell became a leader and organiser at the camp, but food, medicine and other supplies were scarce. A fellow internee, American Langdon Gilkey, later wrote about Eric, "He was overflowing with good humour and love for life and with enthusiasm and charm. It is rare indeed that a person has the good fortune to meet a saint, but he came as close to it as anyone I've ever known." Eric Liddell died of a brain tumour in 1945, 5 months before liberation from the Japanese. Langdon Gilkey later wrote about Eric's death, "The entire camp, especially its youth, was stunned for days. So great was the vacuum that Eric's death had left. Eric Liddell had given his life to God. His last words were, 'It's complete surrender.'" In 2008, just before the Beijing Olympics, Chinese authorities revealed that during the war, the Japanese had made a deal with the British for prisoner exchange at Liddell's camp. Liddell had refused an opportunity to leave the camp. Instead, he had given his place to a pregnant woman. Eric Liddell was an outstanding athlete, a sportsman, a man of Christian values, and a Christian we honour.